Good morning, welcome to the Sunday News Update. My name is Omondi Otieno, but first, let's get to the news headlines where we find the night curfew times have changed from 9 p.m. to 4 a.m. Countries that have lifted the ban on places of worship and on politics. We find Deputy President William Ruto holds meeting with Nandi elders as a purge on allies continues. On the business news, we find that Kenya is now the third largest economy in sub-Saharan Africa. The night curfew times changed from 9 p.m. to 4 a.m. President Uhuru Kenyatta's announcement did not bode well with Kenyans, who were highly anticipating the direction the country was going to take with the set COVID-19 measures. The government extended nationwide curfew that was put in place to curb the spread of COVID-19 by another 30 days. While addressing the nation from State House on Nairobi Saturday, President Kenyatta said that relaxing measures by 20% would lead to 200,000 new infections and 30,000 deaths by December. He, however, said the curfew will run from 9 p.m. to 4 a.m. starting today. And on the ban on gatherings, he said the cessation of movement into and out of Eastleigh area of Nairobi and specific limitations in force with respect to Mombasa Old Town area that is currently in force shall lapse today at 4 a.m. The cessation of movement in and out of Kilifi and Kwale counties have also been lifted starting today, 4 a.m. The countrywide ban on gatherings has also been extended for another 30 days, same as movement in and out of Nairobi, Mombasa, and Mandera counties. President Kenyatta said the number of COVID-19 cases has risen to 2,600 after 126 tested positive in the last 24 hours. He ordered education, health ministries to issue guidelines on gradual return to normalcy in education sector by mid-August. And on countries that have lifted ban on the places of worship, some countries across the world have either reopened their churches or planning to soon resume liturgical activities. Going by President Uhuru Kenyatta's speech yesterday, talk of reopening the country and easing restriction is still ripe. One of those is places of worship. In his speech on Saturday, President Uhuru Kenyatta said that an interfaith council will be constituted in 1 week to come up with the solutions on how to reopen churches and mosques, even as COVID-19 infections continue to rise. Her neighbors, other East African countries such as Uganda and Rwanda, the matter is not yet up for debate. However, some countries across the world have either reopened their churches or planning to soon resume liturgical activities. And on Kenyan politics, Deputy President William Ruto holds meeting with Nandi elders as the purge on allies continues. Deputy President William Ruto on Friday led a group of Jubilee leaders from Rift Valley to a dawn meeting with Kalenjin elders in Kapsi Siwa, Nandi County, in what is believed to be a quest for blessing to run for president in 2022. The Deputy President convoys arrived at the home of the retired Anglican cleric James Bassey, who is a member of the Talai Elders Council, and held 3-hour talks with the elders from around 5 a.m. to 8 a.m. The Talai descendants of the legendary Nandi leader Koitalel Samoei are highly respected and known to offer blessing and guidance to people, including politicians seeking or holding top positions. Former President Daniel Toroitich Arap Moi and powerful Minister Nicholas Biwott, both deceased, were conferred the coveted traditional regalia called Sambut by the group. And when the Supreme Court nullified presidential election results in 2017, President Kenyatta and Deputy President William Ruto visited Nandi Hills Museum, where the Talai performed the rituals and blessed them to run again. Jubilee Party Secretary General Caleb Koitany, who is the Deputy President de facto's spokesman, confirmed the meeting took place but declined to divulge the details. And finally, on the business news, Kenya is now the third largest economy in sub-Saharan Africa. IMF estimates South Africa's GDP at 36 trillion Kenyan shillings in 2019, while Nigeria's total wealth was estimated at 44.6 trillion Kenyan shillings. Kenya overtook troubled Angola to become the third largest economy in sub-Saharan Africa, data from International Monetary Fund, IMF, shows. With COVID-19 devastating a lot of economies around the world, including Kenyans, Estimate from Global Lender shows that Kenya is likely to stretch this lead as it inches closer to the leaders Nigeria and South Africa. However, sub-Saharan Africa is expected to sink into a recession for the first time in 25 years, with South Africa and Nigeria expected to register negative growth of 3.4% and 5.8% respectively. That's all we have for you today. Thanks for watching. My name is Omondi Otieno.